to see that, and I think it's actually pretty likely that they'll do something like that, because GH4 was the first camera to introduce 4K, but now 4K is pretty common, so they have to do something to stand out. A lot of other people are talking about 4K 60, and I also think that's somewhat likely. When you're competing with Sony, like Panasonic has to do something a little bit different, a little bit special, and 4K 60, maybe that is a crop mode where you have to crop down to, you know, kind of a sacrifice or a trade-off for the higher frame rate, but I think that's probably likely just as another selling point that they have 60 frames per second in 4K. They'll likely also up the 1080p quality in terms of the frame rates that are offered in 1080p. So hopefully something like 120 frames per second. Right now on the GH4 it has a 96 frames per second mode, but it's a little soft and not favored by too many people, myself included. So if Panasonic will fix that, maybe offer 96 or 120 frames per second in 1080, that would be another huge advantage for them. Now, what else could they do? Well, I think a lot should stay the same in terms of the features you get, like shutter angle, the way that everything is laid out. I don't want the size to change. I don't think it should. Probably won't get bigger, but it probably also won't get smaller. Hopefully it uses the same batteries. I think that's also pretty likely, because I don't think they want to change the GH4. Such a popular camera that I think they want to make it an easy upgrade for people who have the GH4 to move to the GH5. But what else can we see? Well, it's certainly better low light. They always tout that every time the camera comes out, but probably not going to be that significant. Every time a new GH camera comes out, they're always moving up one or two extra stops of a better low light ISO performance, but when you compare it to what other camera companies are doing, they have the bigger sensors and they have the better ISO processing. The GH line is always lacking on it. That's okay for me. I'm totally fine with it because I like most of my footage anyway, but for some people, they really want the low light. Now, are they going to do a global shutter? I kind of doubt it. When you look at what other camera manufacturers have been claiming and adding trend on their cameras, it's really one of those features that just keeps failing to actually pop up. You know, Blackmagic, Pearson Mini, 4.6K, they were like, it's going to have a global shutter, and then they shut the camera without it. Now, Kinfinity and a few other camera manufacturers are moving to global shutters, but you do lose some dynamic range. It's kind of a trade-off and a balancing act when you're talking about how the sensor reads. So I don't think we're going to see a global shutter on the GH5. I would be really surprised if that were the case. But the rolling shutter on the GH4 isn't that bad. Yes, it's noticeable if you're being aggressive with your movement, but for the most part, it's been pretty good. I found it certainly acceptable. Most cameras and movies that I've seen that sensors have rolling shutter to some effect. So it's not maybe a really good thing for me personally. But hey, that's just me. So probably not a bigger sensor, a few more advanced resolution options, and some frame rate added on there. That to me is probably what the GH5 is going to be. There might be some kind of hidden last minute reveal of something exclusive, amazing, you know, can't believe it, but I'm really struggling to see what that could be if they're not going to move to a bigger sensor. Maybe it's some advanced feature that I'm just not thinking of. Hopefully they can, you know what, I hope they actually implement or plug it out for some other log profile that develop in the world. But that should come standard on the camera. These GH cameras are so popular for video, and that's why most people are buying them. Just give us VLogL in the body right again, so we don't have to do any firmware upgrades, we don't have to buy a $100 package that can ship to you, or is it demo option I did, or the stupid code that they send in the mail. Set all that aside, just put it right in the camera from the get-go. And also keep all the stuff that they've added to the GH4. The GH4 got anamorphic mode added through firmware. Keep that in the GH5. Don't lose.